New York's vaccine requirement has brought the NBA's behind-the-scenes battle over vaccination into public view. The league does not require players to be vaccinated, but local rules in New York City and San Francisco that require proof of vaccination for large indoor spaces means unvaccinated players for the city's teams, the New York Knicks and the Brooklyn Nets and the Golden State Warriors, cannot play on their home courts. And over the weekend, the NBA denied a request for a religious exemption for Warriors player Andrew Wiggins. The NBA says 90% of the league is vaccinated. The New York Knicks say their entire roster is vaccinated, but not the Brooklyn Nets, with superstar Kyrie Irving highlighting the NBA's vaccine issues. Irving did not attend the Nets media day today because of New York City's vaccine protocols. And he wouldn't address if he expects to play at home, saying he wanted to keep his vaccination status private. A report in Rollin Stones looked into the hold the anti-vaccine contingent currently has over the NBA and notes that Irving has been liking and following conspiracy theorists online, alleging secret societies implanting vaccines to connect Black people to a master computer for, quote, a plan of Satan. For real. While his aunt suggested Irving could skip Nets home games this season. Matt Sullivan, who wrote that story, joins me. He's also the author of Can't Knock the Hustle. Also joining me is Jemele Hill, contributing writer for The Atlantic and host of the podcast Jemele Hill is Unbothered. This is a wild story, Matt. I read through it today and had to go back and reread some lines in it. It appears that Kyrie Irving is in general a conspiracy theorist. He got in some heat before for questioning whether the earth is round or flat. And in that, you know, previous issue, you know, he admitted to going down some YouTube rabbit holes over the whether the earth is round or flat. So he is in general prone to sort of conspiracy theories. What scares me is it seems to be he's not a lone contingent in the NBA. How big is this anti-vax contingent?
I mean, as you said, Joy, the NBA does have 90% of players vaxxed and counting, but that's a lower rate than the conservative NFL. And my reporting shows that the NBA has an almost secret society of straight up anti-vaxxers. I report in my book that some players originally denied that the virus even existed. Now Kyrie's family is out here talking about, quote, Dr. Fauci. Another player was trying to explain to me for my story in Rolling Stone that masks don't work. And then there's a theory floating around about Moderna mind control that doesn't deserve amplification here. But last year, if the NBA was all in on science and this pandemic-proof bubble, the Hoopers are sick of testing. They don't want to trust the science. They don't want to get vaxxed. They don't want to get tested on their days off. In fact, Joy, they want to go to the club. So it's really a race against time here and fake news for the NBA to basically shame its vaccine deniers into avoiding that next kind of superstar, super spreader event.
You know, what worries me about this, Jemele, is that, you know, we're talking about Black players who have a lot of fans and a lot of influence and are parroting some of the anti-vax stuff that we hear just in our circles. And if they're saying it, if Kyrie Irving is saying it's just a conspiracy, it's very hard, you know, for you to get your cousin to, you know, to get vaccinated as well. There were stories in this about Kyrie Irving going home to South Dakota, going to school events unmasked, and them having to, like, alter the photos because he was violating, like, the rules, going into schools, meeting with young people. This is terrifying. These are people who are open to not just getting COVID themselves, but maybe giving it to other people.
Well, and that's the part that I wish more of the players who are unvaxxed would really understand. It's not just their influence, but their ability to really highlight and be positive role models. Like you mentioned, like it was very moving, the fact that Kyrie Irving has found this connection with his Native American roots. Well, it just so happens that the COVID rate among Native Americans is awful. And he has a real opportunity there to talk to people in his community, not just the African-American community, but the Native American community, about vaccinations. The other thing, too, that's so amazing and powerful about this misinformation is they will trust a YouTube rabbit hole. They will trust Facebook memes. They will trust other anecdotal bad evidence when the best evidence is right in front of them. 90% of the league is vaccinated. And Bradley Beal, who today talked about how he wasn't vaccinated, was so worried about the after effects. Look at the people on your damn team. There's a player in the NBA, Carl Anthony Towns, who has suffered unimaginable losses from COVID, losing close relatives, losing his mother. He himself had COVID, lost 50 pounds, thought about completely retiring from basketball. He was in such a dark place because of what this disease has done to his family. Talk to him. Stop talking to YouTube. And so to me, that is what I don't understand, is that they have top medical experts. They have other players. They certainly believe other players about all sorts of other things. They can see the evidence for themselves, and yet they continue to be in this space of ignorance.
Is there something different that the WNBA, the NFL, and even the NHL are doing, Matt, that they've got such high vaccination rates compared to what we tend to think of as the most sort of politically liberal of all of the leagues?
Well, the NFL is pretty big, so if you talk about the numbers, we probably got 50 or 60 NBA guys who are not vaxxed here that we're talking about. And NBA league sources tell me that if it comes to it, they'll sweep state databases to root out forged IDs, which have become a problem reportedly in the NFL. And, you know, someone like Kyrie is not going to get paid for missing games. And he's got to balance that, right? That didn't stop him from taking a leave of absence in January, precipitated by the Capitol riot and the lack of charges against the cop who shot Jacob Blake. And when Kyrie came back, he and his teammate, Kevin Durant, they skipped the national anthem. Now, nobody really noticed that until I did, but I think these players are on notice now. Are they going to stand for justice and for science? Or, as Jemele said, are they going to kind of pick and choose their battles of influence?
You know, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar was pretty harsh. He came down, he said, they've given up their, you know, their role as role models at this point. But I have to say, you know, as out front as some NBA players, and especially WNBA, but some NBA players have been about things like voting rights, it's been pretty silent. There aren't too many prominent NBA players that are getting out there and saying, let's get vaxxed, and doing that same kind of activism. It's troubling. And, you know, we know that there's a disproportionate rate of death among Black people and Indigenous people, et cetera, if they get COVID. I don't know. I don't really have a question there. I just am going to leave it, let you have the last word, Jemele, because it worries me.
I understand why it would be very concerning, but I think there are rules of sort of unofficial decorum in the NBA. You don't talk about a guy's money. And I think that there is this fine line that a lot of players are trying to balance. They all keep saying this is a personal decision. Actually, it's not a personal decision, because if Kyrie Irving misses these home games, and considering how close the Brooklyn Nets were to going to the NBA Finals last year and possibly winning a title, if this cost them their title chances, this is costing people's legacies. This is costing other people jobs, because everybody doesn't have the job security that he has on his own team. And I would say that for Andrew Wiggins as well. The Golden State Warriors have the fifth best odds to win the NBA title, meaning that they are in play. All right. So if he winds up missing these games because he's not vaccinated and it costs them, then you're costing people a lot more. So it can't be a personal decision when it infects and when it affects an entire community and your team and your organization.
And your hometown fans. You can't even play in front of your hometown fans because of this. And the conspiracy theories, it's too much. Matt Sullivan, thank you very much. Great article. Jemele Hill, you're always great. Thank you.